Bluebird 851, turn right, heading 180. Bluebird 14 Papa, turn right 245, report localizer established 27.
Airbus in the past 48 hours revealed three, a brand new concept aircraft that if all went according to plan could actually enter commercial service by 2035. That's just some 15 years away. The three concepts have attracted a lot of attention, so why not dig deeper in today's video and see what they are indeed all about. The three concepts that were revealed will be the world's first zero-emission commercial aircraft and represent a totally unseen before approach. Included in this are exploring various new technology pathways not used before, as well as aerodynamic configurations that would help support Airbus in their goal to lead the way and the aviation industry to achieve this type of flight with commercial aircraft. The Airbus CEO commented on the historic unveiling of these three new concept jets and said, "This is a historic moment for the commercial aviation sector as a whole, and we intend to play a leading role in the most important transition this industry has ever seen. The concepts we unveil today offer the world a glimpse of our ambition to drive a bold vision for the future of zero-emission flight." Let's get into the three designs, with the first being a turbofan design that would have a range of some 2,000 nautical miles, and in my opinion gives me an A350 type vibe, at least for the design of the front half of the jet. This one is capable of carrying though between 120 and 200 passengers, just short of your NMA, and of course significantly lower than the A350. This type of aircraft would be able to fly transcontinentally and is actually powered by a fast turbine engine that is running on hydrogen instead of jet fuel. Our second aircraft is a blended wing body. This is a design that you may have seen now on multiple occasions, as it seems to be the go-to design for the future. This would seat almost up to 200 passengers and actually see the wings merge with the body of the aircraft. However, the fuselage is quite wide, much wider than what we'd see on regular commercial aircraft nowadays. A wider fuselage enables the cabin space to be bigger and the overall inside design of the aircraft change from what we usually know. The wide fuselage, in addition, opens up multiple potential options for where the hydrogen storage can be. The final concept is a turboprop that would have a range of more than 1,000 nautical miles and be able to seat up to 100 passengers. Airbus notes this is the perfect option for short-haul trips and is powered by a turboprop engine, but instead of a turbofan, it's hydrogen combustion in a modified gas turbine. The Airbus CEO went on to say, "These concepts will help us explore and mature the design and layout of the world's first climate-neutral, zero-emission commercial aircraft, which we aim to put into service by 2025. Adding the transition to hydrogen as the primary power source for these concept planes will require decisive action from the entire aviation ecosystem. Together with the support from the government and industrial partners, we can rise up to this challenge to scale up renewable energy and hydrogen for the sustainable future of the aviation industry." There's still a long way to go before this can be achieved. In fact, airports will need to make a number of key adjustments to the way their infrastructures are in order to transport and also refuel with the hydrogen. This will be crucial for the day-to-day operations of these jets, and of course the airports moving at a smooth speed and a smooth pace. Airbus notes that support from the government on these matters to in turn have the ultimate goal of being more sustainable will also be key moving forward. Now you've seen these aircraft, what are your thoughts? Do you believe they could work in the future? Is this something you personally see realistically occurring in 15 years? Or do you see it potentially going to 20 years and 25 years? Let me know down below, and as always, thanks very much for the continued support, and I will see you all in the next video. Take care and stay safe.